हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल? हेलो, अरे
यस यस ऑडिबल
एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर
मुझे हेलो शुभजीत, एम
यस यस
आई ऑडिबल?
यस हेलो
ओके सर, रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल, शैल आई स्टार्ट?
सर और प्रिंसिपल सर। हाँ
हाँ यम
ओके गुड आफ्टरनून। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी वेलकम टू ऑल आवर डिविडेंट्स और रिस्पेक्टेड प्रिंसिपल, एमिनेंट स्पीकर्स एंड ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स। नाउ एट द वेरी बिगिनिंग ऑफ द वेबिनार, ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमिटी इट इज रिक्वेस्टेड टू ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स, please mute your audio and switch up your video and not to share your screen. This is an humble request, please. Okay, now in collaboration with IQSE, Department of Mathematics, Navodaya Vidyasagar College is now going to organize this international webinar. This is a special moment to us. It is a pleasure to announce that some participants are from abroad and many participants are from corners country. At the beginning of are you requesting our respective principal, Dr. Shafan Shah, to deliver a inaugural speech. Please, sir.
Yes, sir.
We are waiting for your valuable speech. Yes, sir. Please,
sir. Please, sir.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Dev. Thank you. Very good afternoon, everyone. It is my great pleasure to welcome our prominent mathematician or
speakers.
First, I want to mention Dr. Tomore Pal, who is from Bulan University. He is the head of the department and professor. So thank you, Dr. Tomore Pal. You have given your convenient to present your views or to speak on your targeted topic. Secondly, I thank Dr. Mohammad Ali from Khulna University, Mathematics. So I express my thanks on behalf of Vidyasagar College, all the teachers,
all the students.
Teaching staff and non-teaching staff. I express my thanks to you because you have given or you have responded to our call. You have given your consent to speak on your actually target problem. Perhaps Dr. Devi Prasad Achyut or Dr. Urum will state or describe on what topics to be delivered. Thirdly, Dr. Uttam Ghosh is also he was also the of Navodaya Vidyasagar College. So there is no need of actual introduction. He is very much active in the branch. He is an assistant professor, Department of Applied Mathematics, Calcutta University. So I also welcome Dr. Uttam Ghosh because you have given your permission and you have agreed to speak on the topic dynamics of etc. that will be discussed by your departmental head or etc. So on behalf of the Vidyasagar College, on behalf of the governing body of Vidyasagar College, all teachers, students, teaching staff, non-teaching staff, we express our heartfelt thanks to Dr. Somanathpa, Mohammed Adaraj, and Vishas, and Dr. Somanathpa. Thank you, sir, for giving your response. Secondly, I want to congratulate all the participants. We know the participants be happy. If the participants be contented by hearing the speech delivered by Dr. Ali Vishas, Dr. Ghosh. If your speech, valuable speech or special speech enriches or enlightens them, then we will think that the success of our seminar will be a successful one. So I thank you all the participants who have joined from different corners of the country or abroad. I thank you on the behalf of Prabhupada Gita Sarva College. Thirdly, I want to inform the teachers who are the organizing members of the organizing committee. Firstly, I mean, Dr. Uttaman Mundur. There are three conveners, Dr. Uttaman Mundur, Dr. Chinmoy Vishwas, Dr. Bhaskar Chetanjali, who is the Department for Pharmacology. He is also the chairman. So I thank you, particularly these three persons, because their contribution cannot be gainsaid in organizing such an international event. And there are three members in organizing committee, other three members, Dr. Devi Prasad Acharya, who is assistant professor, Department of Mathematics. Dr. Sunil Sinapati, Department of Mathematics. So all together, they are the actually gems of our Department of Mathematics. I want to mention here that the IQSC. Dr. Conman and Dr. Bhaskar Chatterjee is also with us. I also thank Dr. Chatterjee. He plays a very important role in helping the organizing committee to make the seminar successful. Thank you all. This is my welcome. Dr. Devi Prasad.
Thanks to our also, it is announced that his continuous help was encouraged to conduct the seminar. Now, I request Dr. Chinmoy Vishwa to convey the message sent from our honorable president, Mr. Biman Krishna. Now, to Dr. Vishwa, please.
Thank you all. We get a valuable message from our honorable GB president. Sri Biman Krishna Shah.
About the webinar.
He wrote, I am very much delighted. Navodip Vidyasagar College has organized one day international webinar,
mathematics and its application.
I congratulate all the teachers of the Department of Mathematics. Also, Dr. B. Chatterjee, coordinator IQAC, who have taken such
initiative.
I also express my thanks and gratitude
to the participants and resource person.
Hope this webinar will bring a grand success. Thank you all. Now I request to Dr. D. Acharya to take over the session. Dr. D. Acharya.
Thank you, Dr. Bishwas. Now, thanks to our honorable GB president for his very valuable message, which help us in future also. Now, I would request to our head of the department, Dr. Arun Kumar Mandal, to deliver his keynote address. Please, Dr. Mandal.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Acharya. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I express my thanks and sincere gratitude to Mr. Biman Krishna Shah, Honorable President, Governing Body, Navadvip Vidyasagar College, and Dr. Sapan Kumar Rai, Principal, Navadvip Vidyasagar College. I welcome to distinguished speakers, Dr. Somori Spark, Professor, Department of Mathematics, University of Poland. Dr. Muhammad Haider Ali Vishas, Professor, Mathematics, Department of Mathematics, Poland University, Bangladesh. And Dr. Uttam Ghosh, Assistant Professor, Department of Applied Mathematics, University of Calcutta. Also, welcome to all my fellow professors, teachers, scholars, and students from different countries, different states, different universities, colleges, and schools. I also give thanks to Dr. Bhaskar Chatterjee, coordinator, IQAC, Navadvip, participants, and webinar organizing members, Dr. Dev Prasad Acharya, Dr. Swamiran Senapati, Dr. Chinmay Vishwas, and Mr. Subhajit Sen of Department of Mathematics, Navadvip Vidyasagar College. Our Department of Mathematics organizes one-day international webinar, Mathematics and its Application. Now, I discuss how mathematics related to COVID-19. The virus is called Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus 2, that is SARS-CoV-2, and the corresponding disease in humans is known as COVID-19. COVID-19 infects different people with a wide spread of symptoms. Some infected individuals are asymptomatic, some show only mild symptoms, some get really sick, and few develop a full disease, threatening their lives. Why is this so? Why do elder people die more frequent than younger people? How does the virus affect our body? What causes life-threatening conditions? What can be done to alleviate these conditions? Mathematical and computational models help to answer the above questions. Mathematics worldwide are contributing to the understanding of the COVID-19 pandemic. Working with specialists such as microbiologists and virologists on mathematical model that take into account the different situation in different countries. The activities and projects from all over the world provides a global view of the contribution of mathematics to help fighting against COVID-19. Having gathered a team of experts in mathematical modeling of disease, virus, and physiology, they will be able to tackle this complicated problem. International Council for Industrial and Applied Mathematics, that is ICIIM, is a society or mathematical society from around the world. It helps in gathering and supplying information to their present members in the respective societies and represent informative hubs for applied mathematics activity related to COVID-19. Thank you. Hand over to Dr. Dev Prasad Acharya.
Thanks to Dr. A.K. Mandal for his valuable suggestions and valuable discussions. We also thankful to all the members of our academic subcommittee and technical upgradation subcommittee of our college for their continuous assistance. Okay, there is a concept that mathematics is nothing but some calculations of different types. But we now see that besides this, how mathematics deals our everyday life problems, determine their X factors, and find out the way in which we overcome this. These are the beauties of mathematics. I hope surely we enjoy the coming sessions. We have completed our inaugural sessions. Now over to Dr. Somiran Senapati for next session. Dr. Senapati, please.
Thank you all. After a good start, we are now going to start our plenary session one. I request Dr. Devi Prasad Acharya and Mr. Subhajit Sen to take chair for this session. Please, Dr. Acharya.
Thank you, Dr. Senapati. Now, we are going to start our plenary session one. The topic of this session is the impact of microbial diseases of coral under microalgal toxicity overfishing. And this topic will be discussed by our Honorable Professor Somoresh Pal. Before his lecture, I give a short description of Professor Somoresh Pal. But I know this is a very hard to do it in such a short time, but I try. Professor Somoresh Pal is now head of the department and professor of University of Kolhapur. He obtained his MSc in mathematics, applied mathematics, from University of Kolkata, PhD from Jadavpur University, and 1 year course in statistical methods and applications from Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata. He obtained many awards and honors. Some of these are DST ICTP Award in 2007, Indo-US Research Fellowship in Postdoctoral Research at Georgia Institute of Technology, USA 2010, Fellowship under INSA from Taiwan, and some honors and awards from Ireland, France, etc. He is member of some prestigious bodies. Some of these are: he is life member of ISI Kolkata, life
I think there is some technical problem. Professor Pal, you can now start presenting.
Hello, Subhajit.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay?
Yes, yes. You can proceed.
Okay. First of all, I'd like to thank the organizer of this international webinar. I like to thank the principal of Navodip Vidyasagar College, organizing committee of this conference, Dr. Devi Prasad Acharya, who invited me to give a lecture in this conference, and Mr. Subhajit Sen, who helped me very much how to present my slides. Yeah. Thank you all. The title of my topic is The Impact of Microbial Diseases of Corals Under Macroalgal Toxicity and Overfishing. First of all, I like to discuss about the impact of macroalgal toxicity and overfishing on coral reef ecosystem. This is the brief biological overview of coral reef. The coral reef ecosystem is a diverse collection of species that interact with each other and the physical environment. It is the essential feeding and breeding ground for numerous organisms, and the sun is the initial source of energy for this ecosystem. There are some important aspects of this ecosystem. First one is the turf algae. Turf algae are multi-specific assemblage of microalgae that attain a canopy height of only 1 to 10 millimeter. Macroalgae are larger, erect algae often with anatomically complex forms. And coral settle on turf algae, and macroalgae spread vegetatively over turf algae. And it has been observed that high macroalgal biomass can interfere with coral recruitment and reduce the survival of coral. Now, there is a symbiotic relationship between zooanthellia living inside the coral polyps. The reason is that the coral polyps do not photosynthesize, but have a symbiotic relationship with single-celled organisms called zooanthellia living inside coral polyp tissues. And through this photosynthesis, zooanthellia produces oxygen and carbohydrates for coral polyps, and in return, coral polyps produces carbon dioxide and ammonia for zooanthellia. Now, the main cause of concern is the coral bleaching. It is the result of disruption of this symbiotic relationship between zooanthellia and coral host. One of the main reasons is the of this coral bleaching is macroalgal toxicity. Toxin released by macroalgae increases the mortality rate of corals, and during this harmful algal bloom, large areas of corals become depleted. And another reason of coral bleaching is overfishing. In absence of herbivorous parrotfish, there is the rapid increase of growth of seaweeds, and these coral polyps are smothered to death by this rapid growth of algal mats, resulting to coral bleaching. Now I like to discuss about the phase shift in coral reefs. Coral reefs can undergo relatively rapid changes in demunate biota, a phenomenon referred as phase shift. And this degradation of coral reefs is often associated with changes in community structure towards macroalgal dominated reef ecosystem due to reduction. First, I'd like to discuss about the impact of macroalgal toxicity and overfishing on coral reef ecosystem. This is a brief biological overview of the coral reef ecosystem. This is a diverse that interacts with each other and the physical environment. It is the essential feeding and breeding ground for numerous organisms, and the sun is the initial source of energy for this ecosystem. This about some turf algae. Turf algae are an assemblage of microalgae that attain a canopy height of only 1 to 10 millimeters, and macroalgae are larger. Erect algae often anatomically complex forms. And coral settle on turf algae, and macroalgae spread vegetatively over turf algae. And it has been observed that high macroalgal biomass can interfere with coral recruitment and reduce coral survival. And there is a symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship between zooanthellia and coral polyps, because coral polyps do not photosynthesize, but a single-celled organism called zooanthellia living inside the coral polyps, and they photosynthesize for these corals. And through this photosynthesis, zooanthellia produces oxygen and carbohydrates for coral polyps, and in return, coral polyps produces carbon dioxide and ammonia for zooanthellia. And the main cause of concern is the coral bleaching. It is the result of disruption of this symbiotic relationship between Juan Thalia and oral host. One of the main reasons is the macroalgal toxicity, and this toxin released by macroalgae increases the mortality rate of corals, and during this harmful algal bloom, large areas of corals become depleted. And another reason of this coral bleaching is overfishing, and in absence of herbivorous parrotfish, there is a rapid increase of growth of seaweeds, and the coral polyps are smothered to death by this rapid growth of algal mats, resulting to coral bleaching. Phase shift in coral reefs. Coral reefs can undergo relatively rapid changes in the dominant biota, and this phenomena is termed as phase shift. And this degradation of coral reefs is often associated with changes in community structure towards macroalgal dominated reef ecosystem due to reduction in herbivore caused by overfishing. And we investigate this coral macroalgal phase shift due to the effects of harvesting of herbivorous reef fish by means of a continuous time model in food chain. Another term is the hysteresis. In ecology, ecosystem can exist under multiple alternative steady states, and under external perturbations, this ecosystem may exhibit phase shift. Due to ecological feedbacks, ecosystems display resistance to phase shift and therefore tend to remain in one state unless perturbations are large enough. And the threshold of shift of regime and its reversal can become different, and this phenomena is termed as hysteresis. And we observe that the occurrence of hysteresis, this erodes the resilience of coral-dominated regime. I shall discuss the term resilience. Resilience is the capacity of a system to absorb disturbance and reorganize while undergoing change so as to still retain essentially the same function, structure, and identity. And there are three crucial aspects of resilience. One is latitude, another one is resistance, and third one is the precariousness. I shall show in my model that how we can describe these three aspects of resilience. There are actually two types of resilience. One is ecological resilience, and another one is the engineering resilience. I shall not discuss explicitly, but the main difference between these two kinds of resilience is, in case of ecological resilience, there are multiple attractors, and in case of engineering resilience, there is only a single attractor. Now the question is, why we have used resilience in our model? We have introduced resilience to show how much time is taken by the system to restore with different values of toxicity and harvesting after getting perturbed. And it is observed that with high toxicity level, the system takes more time to recover after getting perturbed by coral depletion. And this is the main concern of our coral bleaching. Okay, our basic assumption is that macroalgae spread vegetatively over algal tuff at a rate A. And first one, M is the macroalgae, T is the turf algae, and C is the coral. Macroalgae and coral, they grow on turf algae. Okay, so turf algae is the base. And macroalgae spread vegetatively over turf algae at a rate A, and the colonization rate of newly immigrated macroalgae on algal turf is B. Corals recruit to and overgrow algal tuff at a rate R. Corals are overgrown by macroalgae because
macroalgae grow faster, almost 10 times faster than corals. So corals are overgrown by macroalgae at a rate alpha, and death of macroalgae and coral is adding to the growth of dwarf algae. And the loss of macroalgae cover and subsequent recolonization of algal top due to grazing. Here G is the grazing, G times 1 minus beta M over M plus T. This is the grazing term. Grazing by herbivorous reef fish on macroalgae. And beta, this beta is the harvest mediated reduction in grazing. So when beta is zero, there is no no harvest. And this gamma is the effect of macroalgae toxicity on corals. So the growth of corals is reduced by minus gamma MC. That sum of these three is, sum of these three equations is zero. So there is some conservation in the system. So we have reduced the system to a two-dimensional one. And these are the initial conditions. And we observe there are two equilibria. First one is E naught, that is coral free equilibria, and second one is the interior equilibria, where both macroalgae and coral present in the system. I'm not going into details of mathematical calculations. And we observe the calculated the stability of the system, and we observed that at the coral free equilibria, that is E naught, and this system is locally asymptotically stable if gamma is greater gamma star, where gamma star is certain threshold. Therefore, with high macroalgal toxicity, corals are eliminated from the system. And we also observe that the non-existence of periodic solutions. We considered the Dirac function. And for this, we have calculated the divergence, and we observe that this divergence is negative. And since this is a constant sign, and by Dirac's criteria, we can say that the system has no closed orbit contained in the first octet. There is the transcritical bifurcation. This is the Jacobian. Now, the transcritical bifurcation at the coral free equilibrium, and the system, our original system, undergoes the transcritical bifurcation at the coral free equilibrium when gamma, that is toxicity level, crosses this gamma star. Gamma star is one threshold, and we observe that the variational matrix, that is Jacobian, and we can easily find that one eigenvalue is equal to zero. So in this case, we cannot apply our usual method, that is Hartmann-Grobman theorem, that is the equilibrium is non-hyperbolic, so we have to use another method. I'm not going into details of this mathematical calculations. And we also observe there is a Saddle-Oat bifurcation. I shall describe what is the difference between Saddle-Oat and transcritical bifurcation. And there are some restrictions. And finally, we observe that the system
undergoes its sudden load bifurcation at the coexistence equilibria when gamma, that is toxicity level, crosses some threshold gamma star. Another point is hysteresis, and this is gamma substar is less than gamma star, holds a sharp transition with hysteresis occur. This is our parameter values for numerical simulation, and most of the values we have taken from some references and literature, from already published literature, and as we have estimated these two, that is gamma and this beta, that is harvest mediated grazing loss. This is the transcritical bifurcation at gamma substar. This is the trace value, and this is the determinant value. And red one is the unstable, and blue one is the stable. This is gamma substar. This value is gamma substar. And at this gamma substar, we observed that the determinant value is zero, and trace value is negative, with instability occurs at E naught. For gamma less gamma star, and stability at E naught when gamma is greater than this gamma star, gamma substar. And there is a sudden load bifurcation at gamma star. There is the difference. This is the gamma star, and previous one is the gamma substar. And in this case, we observed this is gamma star, and when gamma is less than gamma star, the system is locally asymptotically stable at E star, and when gamma crosses this gamma star, then we observe that the coexistence equilibria does not exist. And at this gamma star, this determinant value is zero, because we know that one eigenvalue is zero, so determinant obviously zero, and trace value is negative. And this is the bifurcation diagram of gamma versus the equilibrium value of coral coffer. There are actually three zones, zone 1, 2, and 3. And this is the toxicity level gamma, and this is the coral coffer. Zone 1, that is when gamma is less than gamma star, that is for low toxicity level, the system is monostable at the coexistence equilibria. In between gamma substar and gamma star, this is the bistable region. That is, depending on the initial values, the system is stable at E naught and sometimes at E star. And for higher toxicity level, when gamma crosses this gamma star, the system is monostable at
I think there is some network issue.
Shrojit?
Yes. I called Professor Pal. He is joining now.
Okay.
So the sudden load bifurcation at G. Okay. So when G star, this is G star.
Sorry for the inconvenience, but due to some network problem, Professor Pal would not continue his valuable lecture. So I hand over the mic to Dr. Devi Prasad Acharya.
Okay, thank you. It is already announced that due to some technical errors, we cannot continue this panel session. But on behalf of organizing committee, we request Professor Pal to share this PPT, and after getting this, surely we upload this in YouTube channel. We are waiting for this. Also, a lot of thanks to Professor Pal who gave us his valuable time, and the paper was very beautiful and nice. We upload the PPT shortly. Thank you, Professor Pal. A lot of thanks to you from organizing committee. See you again. Now, the microphone is handed over to Dr. Somiran Senapati. Dr. Senapati, please.
Thank you, Doctor.
We start
our next plenary session. I request Dr. B. Acharya and Chinmoy Bishwas, Dr. Chinmoy Bishwas, to take chair.
Thank you,
Dr. Bishwas.
Professor Senapati. Thank you again. Now I am very glad to introduce Professor Haider Ali Bishwas. Title of his topic: Advances in the Development of Anti-Cancer Therapies by Using the Immune Cell as Anti-Cancer Agent, Modeling with Optimal Control. Now, presently, Dr. Bishwas is the professor of Khulna University. He obtained his BSc and MSc degrees from the University of Chittagong, MPhil from the University of Rajshahi, and PhD from the University of Portugal. Professor Bishwas published more than 100 research papers in the peer-reviewed journals and international conferences. Also, he published. He has worked in several research projects under the Ministry of Science and Technology and Academy of Science. He is a member of different research and professional bodies like Bangladesh Pathological Society, Systematic Society of Bangladesh, Institute of Mathematics and Its Application, UK. European Mathematical Society. Please, Professor Bishwas, deliver your valuable lecture.
Okay, thank you, everybody. Now I'm sharing my slide and then. Are you hearing me?
Yes, Dr. Bishwas, you are visible.
Are you hearing?
You can share now.
Yeah, I already shared, but it is opening or no?
Yes, it is opening, sir.
Yes, your screen is now opening. Now you can open the presentation.
Okay, so it is okay?
Okay, yes, it is visible.
Now full screen is okay, right?
Yes, okay.
Okay, yes, so thank you, everybody. And first of all, I would like to thank the organizer of Navadeep Vidyasagar College for inviting me to deliver my present research to share the fellow researcher and my colleagues. So during this pandemic situation, actually we are everybody are in now home, but we hope we may save from this pandemic situation, and very soon the situation will overcome. Actually, my topics is now, I will share with everybody here the topics is mainly on the advances in the development of anti-cancer therapies by using the immune cells as the anti-cancer agents, a mathematical model with optimal control. Actually, we are very much conscious about infectious disease, especially the communicable disease like the COVID now is going on. but there is a lot of non-communicable disease which are mostly responsible for a huge rate of mortality. All right, one of them is the second leading cause of death of mortality is the cancer. So this is actually the non-communicable disease, but the rate of mortality is very high, is more than like the present COVID situation. But we are not so much care of that because it is a chronic disease. It is going on for a long time and will continue for the long time. So I am now here sharing a research recently published also, and it was developed by MSc thesis student, and it is a very significant treatment strategy now presently using in the cancer disease. And this cancer, the treatment is actually using our immunosystem itself as an agent to kill the cancer cell and stimulate the immunosystem so that the patient can survive, even overcome from the disease. So here, first of all, I'd like to just share some outlines. That is, what is the motivation behind this work and our main objective, like what kind of model is proposed here, and about some background of the topics like the cancer. Actually, we are mainly conscious about the cancer leukemia. It is another very important and is in very death killing. It is a killing, also killing disease. All right, even in the USA, it is called the second. All globally, it is actually the second death of mortality. So now, here we will propose this model actually in two forms. One is without any treatment strategy, how the disease, how the virus cell and the immunocell interact in our body. So we will discuss this system in terms of mathematical modeling. And then we'll use the treatment strategy as a control and formulate this new problem in a optimal control problem. And then both the problems, the analytical and numerical solution has been investigated, and the results actually agree with our analytical findings, and very good results agrees with the treatment strategies. Actually, what is now the promising treatment strategy for the cancer treatment? So first, here you can see the non-communicable disease. Actually, there are some more other non-communicable disease like diabetic, heart disease, kidney, so many. There are non-communicable disease. Cancer is one of them, but cancer actually the second leading cause of death globally among other non-communicable disease. An estimated 9.6 million death, that is one in six death. It was estimated in 2018. And only cancer collectively with other non-communicable disease are responsible almost 71% of the total death worldwide. So this is very alarming. And even the report of WHO, recent report WHO says that cancer is diagnosed is in more than 18 million people each year. And this is more alarming, that it will increase to 29.4 million by 2014. This is a very alarming. So this is actually a very severe threatening issue to achieve the sustainable development goals. But actually, once upon a time, it was a saying that when there is a cancer, actually there is no answer. But now, cancer has good answer if it is detected actually earlier stage and undergone a sustainable, effective treatment plan. So we are talking about here the leukemia. This is actually one kind of blood cancer. It is mostly common type of cancer in children, and with 3/4 of leukemia case in children is being in the acute lymphoblastic type. And here you can see in 2020, 60,000 people are expected to be diagnosed with the leukemia. Is alarming. And in 23,000 people are expected to die from leukemia. And only in USA, there is an estimated 3,76,000 people living with or in remission from the leukemia in USA. So, and it is also here, you can see in 2012 to 2016, leukemia was the sixth most common cause of cancer death in only in the USA. So it is a very actually alarming cause of death among the non-communicable disease. So here just we see a scenario, recent scenario of the leukemia is up to 2017. This scenario is actually only in USA in the upper figure 1, you can see, and this figure in 2 in the lower figure, it is the global scenario for the death of leukemia worldwide. So our objective here actually how mathematics can be applied to describe this type of infectious or non-infectious or communicable non-communicable disease. How we mathematician can be a part of the global this pandemic or epidemic region model, so that a good strategy for the treatment or the prevention can be achieved, so that the social worker or the planner can make a good solution for the treatment of this type of disease. So here we are going actually to propose a very simple type of deterministic model. We call it SIR type model, because in epidemic model, the present, all the participants here, I think everybody knows there are some type compartmental model in the mathematical study. One of these is SIR type model. S is locked, it is actually susceptible, and I is infected, and R is actually recovered. But we consider here the susceptible cell and the infected cell and our immuno cell. So these three types of cell have been considered here to describe these cancer cell and the immune system in our body. And also we validate this model analytically under the basis of the basic reproduction number by proving the stability of disease free and the endemic points. And then we propose this model to modify for a specific treatment strategy. What is now the promising treatment strategy now are going globally for the cancer treatment. We use this two type of control here, and I will show next this control, and then we formulate this problem in terms of optimal control problem. And again, we validate this model analytically and also show numerically that our treatment strategy can be effective way for the treatment of this cancer. So this is actually our main objectives. So now here you can see some background of these topics. Actually, we are called leukemia heart. Leukemia is on kind of blood cancer, as I told in before slide. But what is actually leukemia? It is explained in Greek word that leukom and emia means white blood cell. So this is a blood cancer, especially our white blood cell when become abnormal growth, then this leukemia happen actually. we know that a lot of a blood cell from our bone marrow are produced. These are called the red blood cells, white blood cells, and the platelets. We all know these three types of blood cells are produced from our bone marrow. And also white blood cells are produced from the spleen and lymph nodes. What we call the white blood cell is lymphocyte. So these three types of blood cell we actually consider here the white blood cell, how we call the leukemia. So when leukemia happens, our bone marrow actually and spleen and lymph nodes, they cannot produce a good normal cell, healthy cell. So millions of abnormal cells and immature white blood cells are produced in that case. And in all that case, our red blood cells, white blood cells, and the platelets cannot do their basic functions in the case of leukemia. So here we can see just this figure from the source internet that this is the normal cell, how it looks like. You can see our red blood cells with the red one and the platelets, and also the blue one with the white blood cells. So this is the normal structure of our cell. But when leukemia happens, you can see the white blood cells become abnormal, and it actually goes abnormal growth of the cell. Here we just shown here the cancer division, how the cell actually, because our normal cell always divides and new cell for the normal division of the cell. But when the cell is normal, thus some cell are damaged, and it is the cell suicide, and it is actually mixed with our blood vessels and then go outside at the oestage. But when the cancer happened, leukemia happened, there is a lot of cell cannot repaired, and then it become a normal abnormal growth of the cell, and you can see the uncontrolled growth in that case. This uncontrolled growth actually we call it cancer. So we need actually better treatment and the earliest stage detection for this cancer, because now you know everybody that cancer is not so much there is a lot of treatment actually for the cancer, and if the cancer is detected in the earliest stage, there about 30 to 50% cancer can be cured. Even some cases in the leukemia case, 83% cases can be recovered with the proper treatment. But the most treatment actually we use first the surgery or with chemotherapy. Sometimes we have to use the radiation therapy and some targeted cell therapy. It is called the hormone therapy. So there is a lot of stages of the treatment, but one of the stages is anti-cancer immunotherapy. What is the topics of our present talk? Actually, what is called is immunotherapy. We know immunotherapy actually is one of the most effective varieties of chemotherapy, who is not only kill the pathogen in the body, but also help increasing long-term internal resistance of our immune system so that the body itself can fight against the virus. So it is very important now in the present cancer treatment, because if we use drugs or the chemotherapy or radiation therapy, it has a huge side effects. You know, the patient who have been treated by the cancer chemotherapy or the radiation therapy, there is a lot of side effects, and also some healthy cell also damaged. If we want to kill the cancer cell, but some healthy cell is also damaged due to the chemo, we know everybody it happened. But if we use the anti-cancer immunotherapy for some other, this immunotherapy we use actually our immuno cell for the anti-cancer agent. And there is another way of treatment is oncolytic virus, you know, There is another virotherapy, we call it virotherapy. This is all another effective therapy. But now, today, I just talk about a adoptive T-cell therapy. It is called actually the chimeric antigen receptor or CAR T-cell therapy. It is actually called the engineered T-cell therapy, engineered immuno-T-cell therapy. So there is a lot of names we can use. It is also called the gene therapy. So what it actually works, how it works about in the CAR T-cell therapy. The CAR T-cell therapy actually is a, we usually some cell, healthy cell from our immunosystem or the immunosystem from the patient, it may be the cancer patient or some other individual, we just take a mono cell and then the cell is engineered in a laboratory, and then this cell again implanted in the body, in our inside, in the type. And when it is stimulated, the cell become very ferocious to identify the location of the cancer cell, and then it attack the cancer cell and destroy all the cancer cell without minimum side effects. Even there is no side effects to use. So they destroy not only the cancer cell, actually stimulate our host anti-tumor system responses. And here you can see the CAR T therapy is actually on-time treatment for the beta cell, the acute lymphoblastic leukemia, which has shown 83% remission rate after 3 months in the patient that do not respond to the standard treatment. So this is a very promising and now a new era for the treatment of the cancer. And here you can see this treatment, how the CAR T cell therapy, how it actually works, look like. You see here, this red one is called the CAR T cell. It is actually engineered. It is our immuno cell. It has been engineered in a laboratory, and then it has been implanted in the body. And then when this cell has been stimulated, then it identifies this cell. This is called the cancer cell. This is called the leukemia cell. This is the yellow one. And it is very become ferocious. If you see, it is searching the cancer cell and kill the cell. So this is a promising technique for the treatment of the cancer with minimum side effect. So now, how actually this cancer cell and our normal cell and our immunosystem actually works inside the body. We just consider here three components. One is our susceptible cell, because our white blood cell is all cells actually are susceptible after producing from the bone marrow. It is actually becoming susceptible. So we call it susceptible, and this is the actually the recruitment arm. This is the recruitment arm. It comes from the bone marrow and it immediately goes here in susceptible group. But this cell has a normal cell death, because some cell has normal death. It is called the natural death rate. But some other cell, when it becomes actually infected, we call the rate of infection is beta. So when this cell is infected, it immediately goes to the infected cell. And also the infected cell have some natural death rate. We call it beta naught. But when the infected cell have we can use naturally some drugs or something, it become recover. And when the cell is recovered at the rate alpha, then our immunosystem is developed. But if it is not recovered, then our immunosystem can be damaged. And finally, the patient can be severe for the cancer and finally goes to the death, unfortunately. So this three state, actually we call it SI type model. And considering this figure, this model actually is formulated is very simple in this way. You can see here, this is the source term in the first equation. This is the source term, and this is the natural death rate. It goes from here, and this is actually the infection rate when it is infected, then susceptible, it is deducted, it is subtracted from here. So it immediately comes in the infection compartment, and here is also some natural death and some natural recovery rate. So all this natural recovery comes here in our immunosystem. So our immunosystem is developed, and also this is actually the problem, like initial value problem. So we should have some initial stage is non-negative. All these values are non-negative. So this is a very simple model we can use. And as usual, we know that if we propose any mathematical model in terms of differential equation, actually before going further operation, further analysis, actually we need to verify whether actually this model is valid, or the model have the solution, or the solution is solution have the unique or non-unique. So there is a lot of things need to be verified analytically. One of them is the disease-free equilibrium. We have this type of disease-free equilibrium. I don't show here details the analysis because this model you can find in the references that we have. This paper is already published, is a very good journal. And we have endemic equilibrium point is like this, and also the basic reproduction number. We call the basic reproduction number, we know everybody. This is the ratio of the primary and the secondary infection. So this is the very mathematical term we have all verified, and these results is shown here. Only the result is here. And this under this theorem, the stability has been proven for the stability of disease-free and the endemic equilibrium points. So this theorem has been proved for this stability analysis. And finally, you can see our numerical results, how it can looks like for the very common first time series for the three compartment. You see susceptible blood in the inside the body, how it looks like. Because when the infected cell is rising, then the susceptible cell is going down, and also the immuno cell is going down, is going to zero. So this is the normal scenario inside the body when the patient is cancer infected, when cancer is identified and the patient is goes to severity stage. So this happens inside the body. So actually we need treatment. So everything, it shows that actually treatment is the way for preventing or controlling this type of leukemia or this type of cancer. You can see here is a susceptible cell, because all cells coming from the bone marrow is susceptible. And if you see here, the beta rate is actually our infection rate. When the infection is rate, when you see the infection rate is rising or it is high, then actually the susceptible is going down, because susceptible is becoming infected, and the infected cell, you see the infected cell is going down. When the beta is rising, that is the infection is bigger, then the infected cell is going up, it is rising up. So this is the normal scenario what first we are presenting here before taking any control, any preventive strategy. And you can see the immuno cell, what our immuno cell looks like. If the infection rate, you see the infection rate is high. When the infection cell is high, the infection cell rate of infection beta is big, and then the immuno cell is very down, is lowest one. And when infection is low, the immuno cell is rising on. So this is the phenomena inside the body before treatment. We call it without control, what happens for our model, for the strategy for the case of the leukemia of the patient cancer. And it is actually the immuno cell, what happened after the recovery rate. You can see here, alpha is a recovery rate. If recovery rate is high, then the immuno cell is going high. But if the recovery rate is low, then immuno cell is going down. So it is also important to recover the cell from the infected cell. So infected cell, how can we recover from the infected cell? Here actually we need the treatment. We need our strategy. How can we sustain our patient for the recovery from the cancer? So we consider here two types of treatment strategy. First treatment strategy we consider here U1. U1 actually it is the immunoboosting drug, because you say that cancer cell actually we need some therapy. We call it chemotherapy or drugs, so that our immune system can be recovered from the susceptible to immune cell. It can be go to directly immune cell when we take some immunoboosting drugs. And when actually the cell is infected by our cancer cell, then we call it infected cell. In that case, we also need the treatment strategy. And here we use actually the CAR treatment, the engineered T cell therapy. What is the most effective treatment strategy now? This is very effective. Why it is effective? Because there is a very low side effects, and also use our immune system, so that immune system can be developed using this type of therapy. So this immune system, when we use this engineered cell inside the body, and when it is stimulated, then this engineered cell identify the cancer cell and kill the cancer cell. And in that case, our infected cell can be recovered in the similar way at the rate of alpha, and our immune system can be developed. And this is actually the anti-cancer agent we are using to treat this cancer for the cancer treatment. And using this to control, our model takes this form here. You can see this is the previous model. We use here this control. It is the cancer immunoboosting drug, and it immediately goes our immune cell. It develop our immune cell. And when it is identified as a cancer infected cell, we use the CAR T cell therapy. That is, we use the engineered T cell therapy, and then the cell can be recovered as the same way and goes immediately in our immune system. So our immune system can be achieved in the equation can be obtained in this way. And here, as usual, we have some initial condition which are non-negative, because of course initially we have some values. And you can see here U1 and U2 we apply here. It actually represents our immunoboosting drug, what already I said, and the CAR T cell therapy, what we call the engineered T cell therapy. It is actually the dynamic optimization. So our main objectives here, this minimize, we want to minimize our infected cell, because we want to minimize our infected cell or maximize our immune system, our immune cell. So we can use maximization of immune cell or minimization of our infected cell. At the same time, we want to minimize the cost of the control measure, how to apply, because there is a immunoboosting drug, there is also a lot of cost involved there. And also this immunocart T-cell therapy, we also have a lot of costing there for the nursing, for the engineering of the cell in a laboratory, and then implant to the body again. So we want to minimize at the time, same time, for the cost. And then actually our model looks like as an optimal control problem like this one. So our objective is minimize this function. It is called actually the objective function, subject to our dynamic constant. You can see here this dynamic constant, our three differential equations, and also U belongs to some measurable control set U, which takes values from 0 to 1 actually, because when U is effective, then it actually works in full speed, we call it one. And when U is not effective, then actually U is zero. So U takes values lies from zero to one, and also X, the initial condition. This problem, here we define all these things, the dynamics and our objective function. And this is actually our optimal control problem. And this optimal control problem also, we need to verify whether this problem has a solution or the solution is unique. So this is called the characterization of optimal control. In that case, we need to write or need to apply the Hamiltonian. Hamiltonian actually is defined in this way because this is the integral part of the objective function and this part is actually our dynamics. And this Hamiltonian gives our optimality condition because a set of optimality condition gives the guarantee to have the unique solution for this type of model. And also we will see in the numerical simulation that our results gives a very good agreement with this optimality condition and a good treatment strategy. So this optimality condition in terms of U1, so here we can find our U star, U1 star and U2 star, what we call the optimal control. And there are another variable, another equation, what is called the adjoint equation. So this is the dynamic optimization actually. If someone here are working on the optimization problem, they are familiar with this type of optimization, but actually this is, we call dynamic optimization because we deal with differential equation. So now the optimal solution here actually U1 and U2 star looks like this way. We can find the solution analytically and the solution is like, look like this one. So this takes the maximum values from zero to this one. And this is from maximum and zero, minimum zero, and this is the maximum, this type minimum. So this is the optimal solution U1 star and U2 star. So this is actually the analytical solution. I am not showing all the details here. If someone is interested, you can find in our paper published in very recently and in the reference, you can show in the references. So now I will give actually the numerical simulation, what our analytical finding says. You can see here, first we apply the U2 control, what we call the U2. If you remember, U2 we call it immunotherapy. And immunotherapy is our the engineered T cell therapy, anti-cancer agent. How do you use anti-cancer agent is, and another is immunoboosting drugs. So in first slide, you can see the infected cell, we are using only one control, another control is absent here. In that case, we have a great results. We have an excellent results without control and with control. You see, without control, the infected cell is high, going very rising. But when we use the control, that is when we use the therapy, that our infected cell is going very down, is going slowly. So our treatment actually is working very effectively. You can see here, immunocell, what looks like our immunocell. In the same way, when we use only the immunotherapy and in absence of immunoboosting drug, that is, in that case, we are not using any drugs. We're just using the therapy. In that case, you see, with control, our immunocell is very rising very high. That is our cell, the count, the number of cell is increasing inside the body. So what happened? When the number of cell is increasing, that means cancer cell is destroyed and our patient can be recovered or even can be remission from this disease or from the cancer. And here our infected cell, when we use alternative way, we use here on immunoboosting drugs. And in that case, in absence of immunotherapy, that is, in that case, we are not using the therapy. We are not using the engineered T cell therapy. When only we use drugs, also in that case, our control, even without control, you see without control, the infected cell is high, but with control, the infected cell is down. So infection is down, because when we can see it is very clearly, because when a cancer patient takes medicine, when a cancer patient takes some drugs or takes some therapy, also we have some recovery, we have some improvement for the treatment for the patient in that case. So this is the fact what we really see in our patient in the society. And here you see, in the same case, when we use immunoboosting in absence of immunotherapy, in that case, our immunocell is very rising at the first stage, very beginning stage. But in the last, again, it is going down. Because what happened? Because only if we only use the drugs, so drugs have some side effect. And also drug have some resistance power. So inside the body, if you use continuously drug, so at that last, at the stage, it become immune or it become resistant. So in that case, immune cell again going to down, and then in that case, cancer cell may become a rise, and the patient becoming more severity again stage in that case. So here now we use the both treatment strategy, like both the immunoboosting drugs and the immunotherapy, both are effective. And in the same case, we are using, we see here the infected cell. You see infected without control is also rising, without control, and with control, of course, the infected cell or infected, how do you call, the cancer cell is destroying, or cancer cell is going solo. And also in the immunocell, in the similar way, when two strategy is effective, our immunocell is rising. Our immunocell is increasing inside the body, inside the blood. And without, it is decreasing. Immunocell is decreasing. So we actually want our immunocell is increasing, because immune system, if we want our immune system develop, in that case, our immunocell inside the body should be developed and should be increased. So this is the case, and the basic reproduction number, we can consider, we can analyze it under the basic reproduction number. Because you see, when basic reproduction number is greater than 1, in that case, the disease continues. And that, in that case, you can see here, the basic reproduction number is rising. Because when the rate of infection, that is rate of infection, we call it beta. When the rate of the infection is high, then the basic reproduction is going up. This online straight line is going up. But when the rate of infection is going down, that is when the rate of infection beta, in that case, our basic reproduction number is coming slowly and is going less than 1. Because less than 1 actually represents, sometimes it is actually the disease is possible to die out. And but in our case, in our cancer cell, the cell can be improved and the cancer cell can be destroyed, and a patient can be recovered from this case. So this is the work we are working on here. And this strategy actually is continuation. We have another continuation work on this biotic virus, the virotherapy. We also another work on the virotherapy, and these two effective treatment strategies in the cancer. Here you can, we just show here the control in the different case, and you can see our objective function should be minimized here. But actually, in that case, we only use this one, because we have to use both therapy and the drugs, because at the same time we need to the drug and the combination, though it is a little bit higher, but the combination results gives a good effective treatment strategy in this case. So finally, in the conclusion, what we can say, the treatment strategy or the infection is largely depend actually on the infected, the rate of the infection. And the concern, when the rate of the infection is increased, the concentration of the immunocell is decreased in the body. We already see here. and two contour where you use the engineer T cell therapy and immunoboosting drugs are applied, the infection rate decreases significantly and our immunocell concentration becomes higher in the body. So our suggestion, our results give the suggestion that immunoboosting drugs as well as the engineer T cell therapy, that is the CAR T cell therapy, can be a very effective way or the one of the best effective way for the cancer treatment. What can be performed by our physician, by our doctors in collaboration with mathematicians and some other technical person who is a doctor from the laboratories, it can be in collaboration, it can give a good results for the treatment of the cancer strategy for the cancer treatment. So this is the references and the paper one. Actually, this paper is recently published in Journal of Applied Mathematics and Computation, and it is online. You can see in the online. And also, this student have another two. This we have another model in this leukemia in paper four, and also another one is the liver cirrhosis. We have another cancer model in the liver cirrhosis. So non-communicable disease very much alarming in the society, along with our infectious and communicable disease. Thank you everybody, and thank you for your patience for taking care of this talk. And this is the sharing of my talk with all the participants. You can have some comments. I will be happy to provide to share.
Nice presentation, sir. We get inspiration and ideas from your talk. Thank you. There are some questions in the chat box. So I request Dr. D. Acharya to present some of the selected questions to Professor Vishwas.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Vishwas. And thanks to Professor Vishwas. Due to shortage of time, the question and answer section is deleted from the webinar. All the questions will be sent to you through email, and after your response, the question answer will be published in our WhatsApp group if possible. So question answer from your side, when we get the question answer, we upload it and then. Okay, thank you, Professor Vishwas. Nice delivery. We are enriched from your valuable lecture. We are thankful to you for giving us your valuable time. Your idea will help us for developing research work. Again, thank you. Hope see you again. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, the third plenary session will start now. And I request Dr. Somiran Senapati and Dr. Chinmoy Bishwas to take the chair for last plenary session. So Dr. Senapati, please.
Thank you, Dr. Acharya. The topic of discussion in this session, the dynamics of ACAIQR model with the saturated type treatment, a case study of Spain COVID-19. And will be delivered by Dr. Uttam Ghosh. Before his speech, let me introduce Dr. Uttam Ghosh. Though it is very hard to do in such a short time, Professor Uttam Ghosh. Professor Uttam Ghosh, formerly ex-faculty member of Navadvip Vidyasagar College, that is hosting institution, today's webinar. Presently, he is an assistant professor of mathematics of University of Calcutta. He obtained MSc gold medal from University of Calcutta, and he obtained PhD from University of Kollani. He also published 60 research papers in different reputed journals. He also published two ISSBN books
his area of interest, fractional calculus, ecological modeling, epidemic modeling. Now I request Dr. Ghosh to speak.
Thank you. Thank you, Samiranda.
Thank you.
It is hearing. They are all.
Okay.
There is. Okay. Okay. First, I thankful to the patron, sir, Biman Babu. Biman Babu, once upon a time, I was in this institute, only 4 years before. So he is also my GB president. And Shapanda, principal, sir, head was my head also, Arunda, and my colleague, Baby Da, Shamiranda, we three person were very neighbor. Then Chinmay comes, now Shubhajit there. And other my colleagues, faculty member, and the previous two speaker, I thankful to the organizer for calling me for this webinar presentation. My topic is already described, Shamiranda. First, I divide my topic lecture in two parts, because for my information, there are some college students as well as some researchers. So my three topic, first three objective for my BLAB college student and then for advanced students. Also, the college student follow this advanced topic. This will be helpful for their further career. First, stability of solution of differential equation. Here, I write a differential equation dx dt is equal to fx. If I consider this is a linear, this is a one variable equation, no problem. One can take higher variable. For more than one variable, if the right hand side, that is f, please silent the other person. Okay. If fx is depend on t, then the system is told as non-autonomous system. And if fx is free from t, then it is autonomous system. For autonomous system, we can describe the dynamics easily. For non-autonomous system, this is very difficult. First, I am discussing for non-autonomous system. Sorry, autonomous system. If fx is linear, then the integration is very easy, because we can separate dx by fx is equal to dt, then can integrate. Suppose fx is non-linear, then we may not be able to find the solution explicitly. That is, we may not be able to find the analytical solution. But in reality, a system of differential equation, a set of differential equation arises to interpret some natural phenomena. So when we are not able to find the exact solution, then we find the fixed point and find the nature of solution in vicinity, that is in the neighborhood of the fixed point. Here, what is fixed point? Fixed point means, in physical problem, fixed point means what the system has no velocity. In biological system, fixed point means what the system has no growth. So our case, fixed point means where this function is zero, that is where fx is equal to zero. A point x equal to x zero is said to be a fixed point when f of x zero is equal to zero. Then we use the transformation x is equal to x0 plus u, while u is very, very small, such that we can neglect the higher power of u, that is 2 and onward. Then we will got the solution in vicinity of the fixed point. And using this transformation, we get the above system reduced to du dt is equal to f of x0 plus u. After Taylor's expansion, f of x0 plus u into f dot x0. This is 0, so this is u of f dot x0. This is a constant. Then the solution, this is linear equation, then we can find the solution easily. Ut is equal to some constant into e to the power f dot x0. into T. Here, the f dot x0 plays crucial role for finiteness or infiniteness of the solution. If f dot x0 is 0, then the solution will be constant. That is, the system will move as usual, no change there. But if f dot x is positive, then with the increase of t, the system will increase. That is, ut will increase. That is, xt will increase. That is, in our mathematical sense, we tell it as non-stable equilibrium point. It's unstable equilibrium point. And when f dot x0 less than 0, then what will happen? Then when t tends to infinity, then the solution, that is u2, tends to 0. That is, for this part, x tends to x0. In this case, this point is tell as the stable fixed point. In biology or in physical problem, the stable fixed point is more important. Now, I discuss for system of linear equation. This is a system of linear equation, two variable and two equation. And as usual, we assume the solution in this form, x t is equal to c1 e to the power lambda t and y t is equal to this. Then after differentiation and putting this equation, this system reduced to this form. This is a homogeneous system of linear equation. For this system of homogeneous equation, if I want non-zero solution, that is at least one of c1, c2 non-zero, then the coefficient of this matrix, that is dead value of the coefficient matrix, will vanish. And this will give this equation. This equation is known as the characteristic equation of this system. And here this lambda is important, because in our previous example, the value f of f dot x0, that f dot x0 is lambda. Okay, this lambda is known as the growth rate of the solution. If lambda is less than 1, then solution will decay. If lambda is greater than 1, then the solution will go to infinity. Now, this is the characteristic equation after expanding this determinant. Okay, this equation has two, this second degree equation, it has two roots. Suppose lambda 1, lambda 2, and corresponding eigenvectors are v1, v2. Then the solution of the considered system can be written in this form. Xy is equal to c1 v1 exp plus c2 v2 exp lambda 2t. Here, as previous I discussed, if lambda 1, lambda 2 both are negative, then the system is said to be a stable system. And in this case, when lambda 2 both negative, then xy tends to 0 as t tends to infinity. But if at least one of lambda 1, lambda 2 is positive, then when t tends to infinity, then the solution goes to plus infinity or minus infinity, depending on sign of this or this. And when lambda 1, lambda 2 both positive, then the solution diverges. Now, when lambda 1, lambda 2 equal, and suppose this equal to lambda, and v1 v2 the generalized eigenvector, then the solution of the system can be written in this form. Xy is equal to c1 v1 e to the power plus v1 t. This term, this is the secular term. When t tends to infinity, this term will create disturbance here, and this term makes infinity the solution for some lambda. Now, when lambda 1 2 is equal to complex form, that is alpha plus minus I beta, then the solution will be in this form. In this case, if alpha less than 0, then the solution asymptotically decay towards 0. And in this case, we tell this solution as the local asymptotic stable solution. Asymptotic stable. And when alpha is positive, then the solution is asymptotically unstable. In this situation, this is known as either stable focus or unstable focus. And if alpha is equal to 0, then this is a, this will give center-like solution. Now for nonlinear system, this is very much important. For nonlinear system, first we find the equilibrium points as the previous for first order and only one equation. If x0, y0 is the equilibrium point, then use the transformation as previous, y is equal to x minus x0, eta equal to y minus y0, and use this transformation to this equation. And x1, f of xy, g of xy in terms of Taylor series. Then the system reduced to this form, while a11 is equal to del f by del x at x0, y0, a12 is equal to del f by del y at x0, y0, a21 is equal to a22 equal to, similarly can be done. This is the linear part and this is the non-linear part. When we find the we will study the solution in vicinity of the equilibrium point, then the non-linear part will be discarded. Now we will see visually what will happen for a stable node, unstable node. We previously already known, when all the roots are, both roots are real and negative, then the solution is known as, the equilibrium point is known as the stable node. In this case, this is the vector v1, the equation of the vector v1, but direction of the vector v1, and this is the direction of the vector v2. If and both the eigenvalues are positive, then the solution will follow towards the equilibrium point. For transform system towards zero, and for non-transform system towards the equilibrium point x0, y0. In this point, in this situation, if I stay here or here or here, then the solution will automatically converge toward the equilibrium point. Now, if one of the equilibrium, one of the eigenvalue is positive and other is negative, that is the point is saddle point, then what will happen? Then along one eigenvector, the solution will converge towards the equilibrium point, and along the other, that is positive eigenvector, the solution will diverge, the solution will diverge from the equilibrium point, as well as the whole system will diverge from the equilibrium point. And in this case, if I start from this point, it will diverge to outwards from the, first will try to come to the equilibrium point, and then it will diverge from the equilibrium point. This is the saddle point. And for unstable node, both root are real and positive. In this case, this is the two eigenvector direction. And if I consider any initial point in vicinity of the equilibrium point, then it will go outwards, that is far from the equilibrium point. So this is known as the unstable node. Now, when I already told stable spiral, what is stable spiral? The roots are complex. In this case, if the real part of the root is negative, then the solution will converge asymptotically, spirally towards the equilibrium point, spirally towards the equilibrium point in this direction. And this is known as the stable focus. And for unstable focus, in this case, for unstable spiral or unstable focus, when this will happen? When alpha, that is real part of the complex root, is positive, then when I in the neighborhood of equilibrium point, then the solution will go outwards from the equilibrium point along spirally, through spirally. Now, the basic epidemic model. Professor Haider sir already described a complex epidemic model and described the basic epidemic model in very short. This is a three-dimensional, that is SIR model. This is the basic model, and S means susceptible class, who may be infected with interaction of the infected class. That is, I is the infected class and R is the recovered class after some treatment or herd immunity. What will happen at time of infection? We know for COVID case, when infected person come with interaction with the susceptible person, then disease will spread there. Also, if the I is the infected class, come in vicinity of the susceptible class, then this is the infected term. And we know that all person will always not infect. That is beta portion of that person in the interaction portion is infecting. That is beta SI part is coming here. And then this is the recovery part is going there. Since from the above three equation, the first two is decoupled from the third equation. So we are dividing these two equations. This is DIDS is equal to 1 minus this. So for stationary I, we have this is equal to 0. So S is equal to alpha by beta. S equal to alpha by beta. This point will give the max value. Now integrate the previous equation. If I integrate this previous equation and use the initial condition, this can be written in this form. And this is the ln term. If I expand this term, then we will get this form. If this term is positive, then with the increase of time and S, thus the number of infected population will increase. And if this term is negative, then with the increase of S class or time, the number of infected population will decrease. If I define R0 is equal to this after taking common here, beta S0 by alpha, that is, if R0 greater than 1, then this term is positive and this will outbreak, and R0 less than 1, then this will decrease. Here, this R0 is known as the basic reproduction number. But for our purpose, for this model, this is not important. But in the next model, I will discuss about more precisely. Now, incident rate. What is incident rate? When a disease spread throughout the society, then the interaction among the susceptible population with the infected population that follow the rate, that rate is known as the incident rate. When the number of infected population is lower, then we not take any, we not take care. In this case, we take the rate of incident in the form beta I. When it interacts with S class, then this is beta SI. This is known as the bilinear incident rate. But when the number of infected population increases at certain level in the society, then society take care and take awareness, then the rate of infection will lower. In this case, we get in this form. This is the saturated type infection rate. And when the disease stay small time in a system, a small time means 1, 2, 3, 5 months, such like for our case COVID may be there, such like disease, thus disease come in a system, in a society, and stay very small time, 3, 4, 5 months, then it goes to diagnose. In this case, we take this type of non-monotonous function response, that is non-monotonous incident rate. In this case, first the rate of infection increases highly and then it got to decrease. This is the non-monotonous type incident rate. Now another treatment rate. Treatment rate is very important for our COVID situation. So if the number of infected population is lower, then we can give treatment to every person. In this case, we take Ti is equal to Ri. And another one, Wang and Ran proposed another type of functional treatment rate, that is R, that is fixed treatment rate. This is real because in our hospital, in our case, the number of bed in hospital is fixed. So I greater than 0 R. But if the number of infected population is increases, then we are not able to provide treatment every person. So another for one, again modified in this form, this KI, when in between 0 and I0, that is in a certain range, and when I greater than I0, then this is fixed. Jiang and Liu in 2008, this is modified in this form. Here two terms, this is the treatment term, and this is the delay in treatment. If the B is increased, that is delay in treatment increases, then the number of available bed in the system will be limited. Following this model, another person proposed this in this form, that is mu 1 is the maximum number of bed and mu 0 is the minimum number of bed. When I is equal to 0, then we can give facility to every person. That is mu 0 cancel here, that is mu 1. And when I is infinity, then this term will vanish. Then we will have able to provide treatment to a minimum number of person. This is the limitation in bed. Now, our COVID-19 case. For COVID-19 case, we already know this is initiated from the Wuhan province of China, and this is a viral disease. And in this situation, nearly 1 crore of people is already infected, and nearly 5 lakhs of people already died due to COVID. So this is very crucial to thinking mathematically, and the doctors and other medicine person or other person is thinking from their perspective, but the mathematician think from mathematical point of view using simulation. The simulated result may be true or may not be true, because when we apply simulation, then we are restricted in a certain fixed value. But depending on environment and society we were, the parameter value is always changing. For COVID case, we know that when a person is infecting, then that person may not be infectious. That is, suppose a person is infected by COVID-19, and then after 2 to 14 days, sometime it was 27 days also, that is, this is the incubation period. After 2 to 14 days, the infected person becoming infectious. That is, he or she is spreading the disease. So we are considering here another important case here. A large number of infected people is not showing any symptom. That is, there is a large number of asymptomatic people in the system. So we are considering a 6 compartmental model with standard incident rate. This is S is the susceptible class, E is the exposed class, A is the infected but not asymptomatic. Q is the quarantine class. It is our well-known word now. Oh, a quarantine class. And this I is the infected class, but those are in the hospital. And this is the treatment rate. Here is some type mistake. This will be AI. And this is the recovered person. That is, when a person is infecting through interaction with infected class or asymptomatic class, then it is denoted by exposed class. After infection, it is going to 3 part. That is quarantine portion, asymptomatic, that is not showing any symptom, and that person is most crucial for spreading the COVID-19. And this person at the in the hospital. Now, this is a 6 system of non-linear, highly non-linear differential equation. This is the birth rate of the susceptible population. This is the infection rate, and this is the death rate. This portion is coming here and spreading to 3 part: asymptomatic class, quarantine class, and infected with hospital. And this and the another rates I am not discussing here. This is the treatment rate. I here considering the non-linear treatment rate, that is saturated type treatment rate. When B is larger, then the treatment facility will provide to a minimum number of persons. So recovery rate for the due to treatment for COVID case is very important. But one can ask, for COVID case there is no medicine. Okay, this is true. But when a COVID person is infecting and becoming serious, then the person need many hospital facility. As in this case, the treatment is very important. First, I am ignoring the positivity and boundedness first, because positivity and boundedness is important. When the system is positive, then we can study easily, and boundedness also important. Now, the basic reproduction number, we already familiar about this word. The basic reproduction number is most important for the epidemic model. The basic reproduction number is the number of secondary infected person by a single primary infected person. That is, a primary infected person infects the number of new person. That is the basic reproduction number. We familiar from the TV news, the basic reproduction number of India is now 1.2. That is, every infected person of India is infected more or less 1.2%. So a 5 infected person is infecting new 6%. This is the basic reproduction number. When the disease free equilibrium point exists, then the basic reproduction number can be found easily. So this is the new infected person, and this is the other term. This is the other terms from the infection class. Then first find F, that is del F by this is a matrix, and V, this is another matrix. Then F V inverse is known as the next generation matrix. And the R0 is the spectral radius, that is maximum eigenvalue of the of F V inverse. Here for our model, this give two parts, this part and this part. Follow the model. This is coefficient alpha for asymptomatic case and coefficient beta for symptomatic case. So this part is for the asymptomatic person, that is that person we can consider that not showing symptom and outside the hospital, and this part the person are in the hospital. Now the endemic, this is new term. Endemic equilibrium point means when all the component of the system contains simultaneously. This is known as the endemic equilibrium point, especially when the infection term, that is I star, E star, A star, is non-zero. This is the endemic equilibrium point. And this satisfies this equation, where E star satisfies this third degree equation. I am avoiding the coefficients here. Depending on sign and value of coefficient, the number of equilibrium point may vary. Now, for our case, the stability of disease free equilibrium. This is the Jacobian matrix. That is, first I find the Jacobian of the right hand side, then put this value here. This is Jacobian matrix at that point. And the eigenvalues are 2 negative and other 4 satisfy this 4 degree equation. I named this as a polynomial, suppose p lambda, sorry, this function p lambda. P0 is equal to r0 minus 1. And when r0 greater than 1, then limit t tends to infinity, then this term all vanishes. In this case, limit t is minus infinity, minus 1. That is p0 is 0, and p0 greater than 0, and p infinity is minus 1. That is, at least one sign change between 0 and infinity. So this system, this equation must have a positive real root. And if this is a positive real root, then the equilibrium point is unstable. So when r0 greater than 1, then the endemic equilibrium, then the disease equilibrium point is unstable. In this case, the disease will persist in the system. And using Rutherford's criteria, the stability condition can be established when r0 less than 1, then the system is stable. Now, backward bifurcation. This is most important in the biologicals, in the epidemic model, because if the treatment is lower, the treatment delay, or the vaccination, proper vaccination is not introduced in a system, then backward bifurcation arises. What is backward bifurcation? Backward bifurcation mathematical arise when r0 equal to 1, sorry, when r0 less than 1, along with the stable disease free equilibrium point, another stable endemic equilibrium point arises. First, follow the figure, then I will discuss the mathematics. This is the bifurcation diagram with respect to R0 and number of infected population. When R0 less than 1, then this is the disease free equilibrium, this is I0 equal to 0. Then the disease free equilibrium point is stable. And in this case, there is a range from this range, another endemic equilibrium point, that is R0 less than 1, but disease is staying in the system. This is very, very important. So, usually R0 less than 1 is the sufficient condition, but here the elimination of disease depends on number of initial infected population. So backward bifurcation is very important. Now I go into mathematical portion. Suppose at R0 equal to 1, one of the eigenvalue is 0, and this will occur for alpha equal to this value. This is known as alpha backward point. And in this case, one eigenvalue 0, other two minus in epsilon, and this is the third degree equation. If roots of this equation are always negative, and these two conditions, W is the left eigenvector, V is the right eigenvector, and this value phi and psi is positive, then the system will follow the backward bifurcation. Now I am avoiding the stability of the endemic equilibrium point. Shobhinder, time is it? Shobhinder? Okay. Now data fitting. That is, data fitting means we are getting the infected data from the internet. That is, we all know Worldometer is available to find the number of infected population in every country. YI is the exact number of infected population, and YI is the number of per day infected population, and their sum is cumulative number of infected population, and ZI is the cumulative number of cumulative population from the model prediction. That is only number of infected, not recovered. So I take this equation in this form. Dz dt is equal to, comes from the asymptomatic class, this comes from exposed class, and this comes from quantine class. Then the difference of this value, that is number of exact number of infected population and model predicted population, their difference and their sum, the square sum. Our target is to minimize the square term. This is like the SD, standard deviation, only one way is not taking here. So our target will be minimize this value, making zero, but it is not possible always. So using MATLAB minimization software, that is MathContour, many other software packages, we can find the model parameters. And we have estimated the model parameters here. This is the models, and this is the model estimate parameter, and this is the exact value found from Worldometer. Now these are the sensitivity index for what? Sensitivity index for the basic reproduction number. The sensitivity index positive means with the increase of these parameters, the value of R0 will increase, that is disease will spread among the society. And when these values are negative, then disease, then R0 will be, while R0 will decay, and disease will decay from the society. Now, this is the red part, the red dot are the number of cumulative number of infected population, real data, and this is the model prediction. From our data, it is clear that the fitness is good. And this is the red line at the, this is a histogram, per day number of new infected population. The red part are the infected data, the original data, and the blue bars are the model predicted. So this fitness is good. And for studying the fitness, we will study the residual. Residual means a difference between these two. If the residual is randomly distributed, then the model fitting is okay. Now we are considering the effect of the model parameters. I'm avoiding this portion here. So the R0, we initially discussed the R0 of two part. This part comes from the asymptomatic person, that is those person not showing the symptom or outside the outside the hospital, and this is the hospitalized person. And putting the model predicted parameter values, we get the value of R0 as this. This is the R01, that is outer person, and this is the R02 for the hospitalized person. So here the outer person is most crucial, that is asymptomatic and outer person. Those person are spreading the disease highly, and the infected or the hospitalized infected person, their rate is lower. So optimal control, Professor Haider sir already described elaborately the optimal control. I am introducing only the effect of lockdown here. For our initial case, this was the incident rate, that is infection term, and when lockdown is imposed in the system, then suppose U1 into S, this portion, that U1S portion part is not following lockdown, and 1 minus E1 into S portion susceptible pupil following lockdown. Similarly, U2S portion in the hospital is not following the rule, that is proper guidance for treatment, and the doctors are medical person, and other 1 minus E1S person follow. Then this is the optimal case here. If U1 is equal to 1 and U2 is equal to 1, then disease will not spread. That was successful for Italy. When they follow lockdown after 21 day, they got the result, and disease is decreasing there. Now the optimal control model is reduced to this form. This is the optimal control model. Okay, this is the optimal control model, and here optimal control model. This is the one control, and this is another control, and other part remain the same. And we again construct a functional, and this will the minimum value of this will follow. To find the minimum value of this J, we have to follow some specific rule. That rules are known as the Pontagonal minimum principle. In this case, we construct an Hamiltonian, and some rule, that is the adjoint variable lambda follow this equation, and with the transversality condition, that is our target is after a certain time we will control the disease. If I propose the time is t, then lambda it is equal to 0 after that time. So this is the transversality condition, and the auxiliary equations, and using numerical simulation, we can find. Professor Haider already shown this. Now, this is the conclusion. When R0 is less than 1, then disease is easy to control. And when R0 greater than 1, then disease will persist in the society. In our Spain case, R0 is 6 point something. That is when here R0 is greater than 1. When we were taken the data, then disease was increasing there. That is, the disease was not controlled in their country. So, and we give the prediction after July to 2020, Spain will control the disease, that is number of infected population per day will be less than 100. We give the prediction here, we are not showing here. So this is the some backward bifurcation and other important references, and if the student are interested, I can give so many references for their purpose. Okay, this is end of my lecture. Thanks to all.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Ghosh, for your nice lecture.
Thank you.
And also, for important topic. I hope we are enriched from you. Hope
yeah.
your kind cooperation will be yeah. with us future.
Yeah. 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 Okay. Okay. This is my college.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you to all.
Now I would request Dr. Bhaskar Chatterjee, coordinator of IQAC, Navadvip Vidyasagar College, to deliver your lecture. Please, Dr. Chatterjee.
Hello.
Dr. Bhaskar.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Thank you, Shamiranda. Good evening, everybody. And we are nearing the end of a very nice webinar organized by the Department of Mathematics today. At this onset, I would like to sincerely thank all our distinguished speakers for the day, Dr. Samaresh Pal, Dr. Mohammad Haider Ali Vishwas, and Dr. Uttam Ghosh for being with us today and enlightening us with their excellent and illuminating presentations. I would also like to thank all the participants who have come forward to join with us in this webinar. I thank our principal, sir, Dr. Shapon Kumar Roy, and Mr. Biman Krishna Shah, president of our governing body, for their all-time support and encouragement. Finally, I thank the organizers of today's webinar, all the faculty members of the Department of Mathematics, convener Dr. Arun Kumar Mondol, head of the Department of Mathematics, and Dr. Chinmay Vishwas, and all others, Dr. Devi Prasad Acharya, Dr. Shomiran Senapati, and Sri Subhajit Sen, whose combined and continuous efforts have made this webinar successful. Finally, I thank you all for your patience. Thank you.
All the participants are expected to feel from within 3 hours. Finally, we have come to end.
Hello.
Stay safe. Thank you all. Subhajit.
No. Yes. Yes, sir.
Are you listening? Please.
Yes, sir.
Please end the. Yeah.
Okay. Thanks, Dr. Bhaskar Chatterjee, and once again thanks to all for giving us valuable time. The feedback form will be sent by a registered email to every participant, and they must submit it within 3 hours. After successful submission, certificate will be sent to that email.
Okay.
Now it is over. You may leave now.
Okay.